And I'm Carol Goldsmith. The South Carolina Republican Party has announced a date for the GOP primary, and we can tell you it will be held earlier than Florida's primary.
News 4's Tim Waller joins us live now from the News 4 Digital Studio. Tim, this is a battle over who goes first, right?
That is exactly what this is, Michael and Carol. You may know South Carolina has a history of going first, at least in the southern states. But all that changed when Florida announced an even earlier primary date. So today, South Carolina Republicans responded.
South Carolina will hold its first in the South presidential preference primary on Saturday, January 21st.
The chairman of the South Carolina Republican Party locking in a primary date that is now 10 days earlier than Florida's primary, which was set last week for the 31st.
South Carolina Republicans have a 30-year track record of picking the eventual Republican presidential nominee. We will continue that historic tradition on January 21st, 2012.
We also know that turnout increases when we go to an earlier date.
The move is a reaction to Florida's decision to hold its primary earlier than expected.
With 29 electoral votes, Florida has more votes than Iowa, New Hampshire, Nevada, and South Carolina combined. And we proved back in 08 that the person that won Florida became the Republican Party's nominee.
But South Carolina's Republican Party said the leapfrog was a violation of party rules.
But I really think that a state who violates the calendar ought to lose all their delegates.
Today, a spokesman for the Republican Party of Florida said, "We're happy South Carolina maintains its first in the South status." He said Florida wanted a prominent primary date of its own and intended for South Carolina to jump ahead of them by choosing January 31st instead of January 3rd, as lawmakers there had first discussed. But Conley says it's created problems for everyone.
I understand that South Carolina is facing penalties, and we may lose as many as half of our delegates as well.
Here's why there could be penalties. The Republican National Committee intended for South Carolina and three other states to hold their primaries in February, not January. Iowa and New Hampshire, as a result, expected to push their contests earlier into January as they try to protect their role as the two lead-off states in the presidential nomination process. Tim Waller, WYFF News 4, live in the News 4 Digital Studio.